Hello everyone, it's KK Blue with the channel Magic Mango, back with another video. Today we are playing Black Green Rock. And it has the title, Welcome to the Rock. It's a reference from Come From Away, a Broadway musical that is awesome. You guys should go see it. I know, completely unrelated to Magic, but just had to use it. I love this deck to start. It's super fun to play. Like, the entire thing is just making your opponents hate you, and it's wonderful. Basically, the idea is we attack our opponent's hand and kill their early creatures. Ramp a little, hope we can get our big stuff early. Otherwise, we can just discard it to Lily and get value off the Tireless Tracker. It's a very good deck. If we get Binding, we can get a land drop for Tireless Tracker. That's why we're playing the four of Binding, as opposed to other cheaper removal spells like Assassin's Trophy. And so we can get that land drop. We can, and we also have a lot of ramp. It's easy to get Binding on turn three with Wolf Willow Haven, and then Scavenging Ooze. Just you can take out, like, you can threaten Witch Oven and stuff, and Tenacious Underdog, threaten the late game, and Liliana is so good in this deck, because you can put it down, it's a removal spell, and it's something they have to attack, so it gains you life and gets you time, or you can put it down and plus against control and just drive them into the ground, and it just makes your control matchups one, like, so far, I have not lost a single game to control, and I've played this a bunch, and I only lost... And I haven't lost to aggro yet, either. I've only lost to this weird combo deck. And that was the one time. But so far, I'm 5-1, so I'm really enjoying it. We got a Garrick Unleashed. This comes down, makes a token. I'm still not sure about it, but you can plus it and give your Renin 7 token +3/+3 in Trample, or you can give Vivian... if you put it down with Reach or Vigilance, you can give it Trample, but it also protects itself, you get a token. We needed another 4-drop. We could play something else, but I think it's really good in this. The good thing is you can pretty easily pass by on a 1-drop, and then you hit, like, a 2-drop, and then turn 3, you hit this, get another 2-drop, and, you just get straight here. I mean, yeah. We have ramp. It works. And then Elder Gorgoroth. It's a good card. It just comes down and gets you a lot of value. You can gain life against aggro. You can draw a card in most matchups. Or you can create a 3-3 if you need board presence. And that's very good. This is just a little graveyard hate. You don't need to play it unless you're running into decks like Witch Oven, which I have been, so that's why we got the Graveyard Trespasser and the Scavenging Ooze. There are better cards you can run if you're not running into, like, graveyard shenanigans. You can just run another Lily, but the reason I had to cut a Lily is because of this, and Lily's just not good against Witch Oven, and it exists, so that's why we got this. I'm keeping it at a 1-of. It's not that good of a card. I feel like it's overplayed. It's extra damage, but we don't need to win quickly in this. We can grind our opponents out. So, yeah, that's the deck, and let's jump into the gameplay.